Hey kid, welcome to Kid Time Story Time. Do you ever get frustrated because you can't do something right now, or you think that maybe you'll never be able to do it? Yes, yes, just like it happens with Hootie. See, Hootie, hey, he's saying hello to everybody. He says he hopes you're having a good day. Well, Hootie, as you can tell, even though I speak owl, he has yet to develop our language skills. Isn't that right, Hootie? But his reading comprehension, fabulous. And, you know, it's a process, and sometimes he gets a little distracted. Hey, stay with me. So it's a matter of learning something eventually, right? Just because you can't do it doesn't mean it just means you can't do it yet. Yes, I will read it to you. It's something called growth mindset. The idea that we should all have, kids and grown-ups, that we are always growing. That's right, we're always growing. Now, can you see everything? I'm gonna open it up just a little bit because I don't want you to miss a word. Here we go. It's bedtime, Anna. Anna loves all kinds of times. Free time, play time, cookie time, hey. And even brushing teeth time. What about kid time, sorry time? Bedtime is the time that Anna doesn't like. Oh, Anna. Well, I get it. Some of us just love to stay awake. But everybody knows that before bedtime comes, what? Story time. And Anna loves kid time story time. Don't you? Don't look so blue. You're about to get an awesome story. Now, Anna's dad asked her to read the first page. Like every single evening, Anna responded, "I can't do that." Halfway through the story, Baxter crawled into the bed. Her dad pretended he didn't notice. Subtle, subtle dad. Oh, they're both redheads. I guess she got it from her dad. Now, Anna, well, it's funny. She couldn't remember the end of the story. She must have fallen asleep, but suddenly she wasn't in her bed anymore. Where has she gone? She looked around and saw a woman. Hey, it's a redhead book. The woman was tall with long brown hair and glasses. You call it brown? I see red, but okay, let's just say auburn and we'll settle for that. Anna had the feeling, funny feeling, she knew her somehow. They must have met before. It's kind of one of those senses of deja vu. That's what you call it when you feel like you've been somewhere before, known somebody before. "Finally, you're here. I was waiting for you all day long," said the woman. "Let me show you what we've done." The woman smiled and took Anna by the hand. Well, I mean, she knows her, but she vaguely feels like familiarity. We'll figure this out. "Look, Anna, this is our office." Oh, it's a very dynamic place here. "We usually arrive here around 9 in the morning. The team we work with is awesome. We hired a bunch of very creative and smart people." Whoa, this lady is in charge of the situation. "Everybody works together and we lead the technical department." Ooh, she's techie. Well, Anna couldn't tell that the woman, I mean, she could tell the woman was excited, but she kind of had no idea what she was talking about or what she was excited about. And she didn't want to interrupt her because that would be rude. But she totally did not understand why the woman kept saying "we." I mean, Anna had never been here before. And why did this woman look so familiar? Doesn't that drive you crazy when you just can't place the face? "Yesterday was a crazy day." She's still going on with this tour. "The servers went down and everyone was worried. At first, we couldn't find the problem in our code. Our webpage wasn't showing anything, but fortunately, we were able to fix it in just 20 minutes. Okay, Anna was utterly confused. She didn't know even what servers were. I mean, it's some computer thing, right? Or why they were important. But she was glad that the woman was able to fix the problem because, I mean, it sounded like a big deal. But still confused. Then the woman took Anna to a desk, and there she turned on her computer and started writing something on a green background. "Anna, I'm going to take a break. Can you finish the rest of the work?" What? Is it becoming a nightmare? She has to work at something she doesn't know how to do? What? I can't do that. The woman started laughing. Really? And Anna thought she was mean. But her laugh was so contagious that she started to laugh too. Oh, look, they have the same laugh. Is that a coincidence? No, it's not. Suddenly, the woman got up and went to the fridge. Oh, yum. She put the celery sticks and a jar of peanut butter on the counter, and slowly the woman started to put a celery stick directly into the jar. Now, Anna's mom always told Anna to use a fork instead of putting the celery directly into the jar, but this woman, oh, she is just freewheeling. She doesn't have any cutlery rules. Anna still could not remember this woman's name. So she finally asked. I mean, at some point she's got to ask, right? You're telling me all these things, but I don't even know your name. The woman looked Anna in the eyes and said, I'm you, and you are me. Mind blown. That was not possible. How can one person also be another person? The woman stood up from her chair and whispered, My name is Anna, and I'm a possible version of you in the future. The only thing different about you and me is time. Time, time, time to see what's become of me. No, 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 no. Anna was confused. That can't be true. I don't even know what you're talking about. Server, code, I can't do any of that. You can't do that, Anna? You can't do that yet, because you haven't had the time I've had. When we were 16, we started to learn computer programming. Oh, because she knows the past. We made this little game, and everything just went from there. You really wanted this, and so you created me, just like you created this game. Oh, wow, she created a video game that became a big thing. Oh, but I don't remember any of that. Well, how could you? This is the future. If you want this, it could be your future. Oh, so she's from the future, but she's saying the future can still be changed. Ah, because you're still writing it. Anna couldn't believe what she had just heard and seen and experienced. How could all of this be possible? She wasn't like this woman at all, but maybe she really could be like her. I mean, this future seemed exciting. And I had so many thoughts at once that she wasn't able to say anything. She just jumbled in her brain. The woman said that Anna could be her if she wanted, but what if she didn't want to be her? Oh, the thoughts are just going around and around in her head now. All the possibilities. Anna didn't want to hurt her older self's feelings, so she didn't say anything. I feel like Anna like keeps quiet a lot when she's confused. Anna's older self looked at her and said gently, You don't need to say anything. I know exactly how you feel. Ah, because she knows herself, right? So she knew how she was feeling. I want you to meet a few people before you have to go. All of them care about you very much. Oh, more people from the future? What are we gonna... We're going into a door. She's looking in. She's looking a little surprised. What are we gonna find? With these words, she opened a door wide, and Anna could see what was inside. The room was full of Annas. There were so many Annas that she didn't know which one to focus on. Wait, we have, it looks like airline pilot Anna, and doctor Anna, and businesswoman Anna, and professor Anna, and scientist Anna. Each one seemed different, but at the same time familiar, you know? That same je ne sais quoi feeling, because it's her. Nobody seemed to notice little Anna, and everybody was just so focused. And she wished she were able to stay forever to meet every single one of them. And just when she had the courage to finally step into the room full of Annas, slam, the door closed. The door closed. Suddenly, Anna's feet started to feel wet. She heard a voice far away. The voice told her that she had to go now. She then heard her older self telling her one last thing. We are always inside you, even when you don't see, feel, or know it. Anna suddenly felt Baxter licking her feet and quickly realized she was back in her bed. That's the wet feet feeling she was having. Oh, the door closed on the dream and they left her with a final message. She got up right away and went and told her dad, I want to try to read the first page tonight. With a little time, I'll get it right. I just can't do it yet. I can't do that yet. That's the key. Just because you can't do something doesn't mean you never can do it. It just means you can't do it yet. But you keep striving for it, which means working for it. Working and learning and practicing until you can do it. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Yes, you are going to continue to take your English classes. Ooh, and you are going to learn to speak words, more words than what you speak now. Ooh. Hootie, do you wanna show the Kid Time Story Timers the words that you can say? Ooh. Oh, don't be shy. Ooh. They won't laugh at you. Ooh. No, they're very supportive. Hello, 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 I'm Hootie. No, don't be shy. You did a good job. You did. Yes, yes. You should be very proud of yourself. Aren't you proud of him? It took so much effort to say those things because you can't do it completely yet. But one day, one day you will do great things. Until next time, kid, keep growing. Keep your mind set on the future. Keep working, keep trying, and have faith. Don't say no when you have a chance to do something new. Say yes and try and try and try until you can. See you next time on Kid Time Story Time.